Are we good? Oh, good. We're halfway through, aren't we? Simon Yell from Biffy Clyro. We're backstage at the Q Awards. Q Fender Play Award, I believe.
Yeah, yes. How about that? How do you like them apples?
I know. Guitar hero,
it's,
Simon.
It's crazy. Just, I mean, Dwayne Eddy handed over the award. Right. I can't quite, my little brain's just exploded about that. Yeah. But yeah, it means a lot to me. The guitar is an important part of my life, whether I like it or not.
Yeah,
so
yeah.
It's an honour to get it.
When did you first pick it up, as it's a guitar award?
Probably when I was 12. Actually, my parents made me play violin for a good few years. And yeah. I think that influenced my guitar playing more than anything. So
do
when
you?
I picked up guitar, I had no basic knowledge of it. Everything came from the violin. So I think from the moment I picked it up at 12, I didn't know how to play it. And I think that's a good thing. I think I still don't know how to play it. But
I think you do.
Oh, well, thanks. I try.
What's your, have you got like a workhorse guitar and then like your treasured beauty that you keep at home that never goes out on the road?
Yeah, I've got a couple of them actually. I've been lucky the last few years. I've been a very naughty boy when it comes to guitar
stores. Are you on eBay all the time? Just sort of
I've got a favourite shop in LA. It's called Norm's Rare Guitars.
Okay.
Big up, Norm. Give me a free guitar. And he just has these wonderful things. So I just bought an SG from 1963 in a Martin acoustic from 1970.
Wow.
So that's kind of my fetish at the moment. Yeah, that and trainers, but guitar specifically. So yeah, I've always got a new kind of special one. But I've still got my very first guitar that I had that's covered in guitars. So that hangs on my wall in Pride of Place, which was about £70. So.
Yeah, really nice. So you just did some strip back shows, didn't you, as well? So like sort of, you know, completely changing it. Amazing reviews. I didn't get to see them, but I saw the set and I heard wonderful things about it. So did you enjoy working that different kind of?
Yeah. I think, you know, we've been touring as a heavy rock band for about 20-odd years. It was really nice to do something a little different.
It
was weird though, sitting down. I mean, we were used to playing with our shirts off, getting really stuck in. It was weird sitting down, staying clothed, but it became something different. It became like a more of a celebration of the songs. So it really meant a lot to me as a guy that writes the songs to see what the certain lines mean to the crowd. It was really, it was kind of like a real intimate connection in the whole tour with the fans. So I'm really glad we did it.
Yeah, absolutely. I'm being told to wrap up because there's so many people here.
Oh, yeah,
and I wanted to talk to you about the Glasgow School of Art and the film.
Yeah,
and
so
album
with a movie is coming out. The movie's just finished. It's called Balance Not Symmetry. The album will be out in January. 8th album coming up, and we've got lots of excitement.
And the School of Art is being rebuilt again.
Finally. I know, and bloody hell, I hope they look after it this time. It's excruciating, but it's a really a cultural.
So important.
It's so integral to it. It's the spine of Glasgow. So
Lovely to see you, Sam.
Thank you.
See you later.
A pleasure. Thanks.
Lovely to see you.
Sweet.